Okay, so if I could have everybody's attention. Okay, so this is the well, and I am Pastor Jeannie. We feel honored and privileged that Robby would choose our house and his house for this special event. So we're very excited. And so we just want to welcome you. And so we have Pastor Daryl Rose, and he's going to come and start this service. And we love and appreciate him. He's a great supporter of our ministry. So here you go.
As we begin tonight, I would like to... We're gonna pass the challah bread around right now, so we're gonna give you a piece of the challah bread. So Robby and whoever else is gonna pass it around, take the chunk off. Small enough to where, but big enough to eat. Have a nice piece. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna ask a good friend of mine, Lisa, would you come up here? Lisa is going to, as we're passing this around, Lisa is a Jewish believer in the Yeshua the Messiah. And as we take the bread, I'm going to ask her to pray a blessing over the bread before I read the scripture and have the general pray.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam, Asher Bereshonu B'Mitzvoto Nitzivanu Hamotzi Ha'aretz. Praise be thou, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who gives us the fruit of the earth. Amen.
Now, in Exodus chapter 20, and this is the fourth commandment, it says, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God, and in it you shall do no work. He's going to say, nor your son, nor your daughter, nor your male servant, nor your female servant, nor your cattle, nor your stranger who is within your gates. For in the 6 days the Lord made the heavens and the earth, the sea, and all that is in them, and rested the seventh day. Therefore, the Lord blessed the Sabbath day, and he hallowed it. He set it apart. This is very pleasing to the Lord, what is happening here tonight. Because you are setting apart, sanctifying, and hallowing the Sabbath day of the Lord. And so we're going to pray a prayer of blessing, and then we're going to have great ministry of music. Robby is going to come, and the worship rebels are going to do all the worship and praise. But let's pray, and let's ask God's anointed blessing on this time. Father, tonight we believe this is a holy moment for us. And as we come into your presence tonight, as most of us are Gentile believers, but we know that we've been grafted into Israel. We come tonight, Father. We hallow your Sabbath day tonight. And we believe you, Lord, that you have something very special tonight to release into this place this evening. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory for sending your Son, Yeshua the Messiah, Jesus the Lord, to come into our life. And we thank you for what you've done for us. And we thank you, Lord. We hallow it. We welcome the Sabbath tonight. And we give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory. In Jesus' mighty name. Now let's give the Lord a hearty clap offering of praise tonight. Come on. Give him praise tonight.
They take most of that, so it's really an honor to have them here. And they are my music team, and they travel a good bit. They've also, I've had the pleasure of taking them with me to different places all over the U.S. and Canada, and really been a lot of focus has been towards Native America, and just restoration to our Native brothers and sisters, and it's been quite a journey, and it's really good to have you guys here. They got a brand new album out. You gotta get it. It's incredible. I'll let them talk a little bit about that. And, I got a new album out as well. Just come out today. So, and it's called No Greater Love. And you have any rhythm at all, if you willingly admit you don't have rhythm, then just don't. Because if it gets bad, I mean, we would just have to stop. Okay, let's try to. Now, if you can clap your hands to the beat of a song, then you can play the Father.
Oh,
shake. Cause I can hear the mountains rumble. See the water rise. Feel the wind blow. See the stars out.
Oh, time. Just like you have. Because see, your mind, this is what our mind does. Our mind says, you got to hide all your dirtiness. You got to hide your flaws. You got to hide your imperfections. Because religion will beat you up if you let it out. But see, the thing about David was, here's the thing about the heart of David. David would get mad at God and he would let him know. He would say, God, where are you? Amen? And the other cool thing about David was, even though David knew that he was a messed up person, he never would turn his back on God. He would run to God. And that's the kind of people that our Father digs, man.
Yes.
He would rather take somebody who blows it up every single day than somebody who hides behind their sin.
Amen.
Amen. He's looking for the real. Amen. Hallelujah. I think that's what it is too. We live in this system where you got to do this and you got to be this way and you got to be that way and this way. But David wasn't like that. David was a reject just like every one of us. Rejected by his family. Rejected by Israel. Rejected by his own men. Rejected by his own king. And no matter how bad David was, God never rejected him.
Amen.
Hallelujah, dude. They're preaching up in there, man.
So true.
So, are we going to try to do this song?
Yeah, we got to.
You want to?
It's a new one.
Never done this song.
Just so you know, a lot of you guys, if you'll come here on Thursdays and Mondays, I'll be here leading worship. And a lot of the songs I've been singing is stuff that he wrote. So, yeah, he's an incredible songwriter. He's new and he's great.
Never done a song before, but a couple of months ago, I guess, I had a vision and the Lord showed me where I was seeing like wolves just running crazy everywhere and they were attacking the people of God. And at the same time that I saw that, I also saw the Father releasing lions. And when the lions would open up their mouth, light would come forth and it would devour the wolves. And I say, God, what's the light about? Every time the lions roar, what is the light that's being released? And he said, the lions are my people. The roar are the sounds of my people's praises. And the light is the word that I'm releasing to devour the enemy. Amen.
Like a light
Yeah.
Creator's name in them. And for some of us, we're just learning these songs. So we put these pieces together with the auto drum that God created. God created everything, by the way. Every sound. Worshiper, right? And he knows how powerful sound is. That's why every day we have our young people singing curses over their eyes to secular music. It's not just by chance, it's very thought out by the enemy. Right? And for a long, long time, the drums deemed to be evil.
mutual friend of ours. He's an amazing, he's been such a mentor to us, Robby and I. And worship leader out of Ireland named Brian Houston. And sometime last year, I think it was, maybe last year, somebody took him to see one of the last residential schools that closed down in Canada in Spanish, in northern Spanish, in Ontario. And the Lord gave him a song about it. And later on, we all were hanging out in Nova Scotia. And I remember clearly we're having dinner. Am I telling you wrong?
No.
Okay. She's shaking her head now. I don't know what that means. And I remember I was just sitting minding my business, like finishing my dinner. And next thing I know, our friend Ryan turns to me. He goes, "So this Friday we're going to the studio and we're going to record a song and you're going to sing it." And I'm like, "What song are you talking about?" And it was this song, and he said, "I really feel like I need you to help me rewrite this song from a native man's perspective." And I said, "I'd be honored to do it." And so this song is called Carla. It's a song about forgiveness, but it's also the story of what happened to our native brothers and sisters in the residential schools of North America.
Took me to the side of a residential school that closed down in the summer of 1962. I looked out on the land where bitter tears had flown and offered my forgiveness for the bitter seeds they stole in time.
Couldn't speak our language, though we couldn't sing.
Teach them to be Catholic. And
But when we were in North Dakota, and even in Canada too, Canada was the residential schools went on for years. They were shut down here, and then they went on, I think, into like 1970 or something. You can correct me if I'm wrong. But so when we're sitting and we're singing, no, we're no longer orphans in front of Native. Our congregation is 90% Native American. We're mostly full bloods. Almost everyone in that room, especially if they're from Canada, that was like Native there, were raised in a residential school, meaning they, when they were 5 years old, they were snatched out of their mother and father's home. Could you imagine? Someone coming to take your five-year-old and saying they're going to live in a school now because of your color of your skin, because of the way you talk, because the color of your hair. And this wasn't very long ago. So most of the people were singing these songs, were singing to someone who was an orphan. So the little lady was contacting me through Facebook, and she was just going on and on about the song, and then it just hit me. I was like, my God, this song is for all of us. But it's really, I believe God is making me do it. Maybe he didn't when he wrote the song. He really wrote it to bless our Native and our Native brothers and sisters, and to let them know, along with us, that we are no longer orphans, that we are now a family. And the kingdom of God is where you can be a family, whether you had a mom or a daddy, and it doesn't matter, because ultimately we have a Father in heaven who loves us. That's the gospel story. It's a beautiful one. So I want y'all to really pay attention. Go ahead. Listen to this word.
because he first loved me. Come on, time. Because he first loved me. Jesus loves me. Is
better than what you could ever thunk up. Amen. That's the word.
That's the word.
awesome.
Right? It really is. And I'm a total witness to this, guys. And I really thank and honor my spiritual mother here, Miss Betty, for praying for me through all the times. And how many has a spiritual mama in their life? If you don't, you need to find one. Because they're around. It's so important, guys, to have someone to be accountable to. You know, we're tribal people. Tribal means a whole bunch of us. We're not meant to be lone wolves. You know? So, I want to do one more song. I always want to get everybody, if you could, I wanted to make a circle. I've actually been wanting to do this all night, but I think it's proper that we do this now. We could just go along the whole outside the wall and everybody join hands. One of the things that is also kingdom is circles. Because in creation, everything is round. Every planet, every tree, everything is round. And corners are man's doing. Right? Whenever you have corners, there's always someone up front. There's a front, there's a back. And in the circle, everybody's in unison. So.
Amanda, bring it over here and connect
it up. So I started singing this little song.
Make us one. Make us one. Make us one. try every time it's make us strong. Make us strong.
Excited about all of us here.